Hi everyone, welcome to the Kraaft Shaak. I'm Heather, and I know it's been a while, so I wanted to make sure you knew who I was. Things have been crazy, and I can't really fully explain everything that's been going on. So, I mean, there's just not enough time. And honestly, who wants to sit through something like that? It hasn't all been good. So, it's just easier to say that life has thrown us some challenges, and that's been going on for a while. So if you take a look back at the last 18 months, things have not been where we expected them to be, and things went a little sideways based on what we had planned. And you know, that's just the way life goes. I just want to take a minute and say thank you to everyone who has been wondering where we've been, what's been going on, and what is happening with the Kraaft Shaak. I really do appreciate your emails and your comments on Instagram and any of my YouTube videos or anywhere that you've been placing your comments. I really appreciate it. I've received some great emails from friends just checking in to see where things have been. I haven't been on the internet much these days, and that is true. That's true. So I appreciate the fact that you guys have been checking in on us. So thank you for that. The other thing I wanted to say is that if you're new here and this is your first time watching one of our videos, or maybe you've watched one of our art videos before and now you're watching this and thinking, oh great, it's another vlogger. I really am not a vlogger. I don't do this very often. I thought that it was something people did want to see at one point in time, and that became very clear that this is an art channel and I don't normally do these types of videos. So that's the reason why you're watching some sort of artwork take place while I'm chatting. So if this is not something you don't want to hear big news, you don't want to hear updates, you don't want to hear any of that stuff going on, then push mute and just watch. And for the rest of you who actually do want to know what's going on, this is for you. So, I guess what I just need really to be clear about is that life for all of us is difficult at times. And for some, the difficulty lasts a lot longer. For some, the difficulty is unbearable. It is so tough that you're just looking for a positive place to hang your head and to spend your time. And hearing a video or watching a video of somebody else having difficult times is not always what you want to do with your time. And so I appreciate that if you are going to watch this video and listen to my message that I want you to know that I appreciate you for that, because honestly, I don't want to record this video. Not to say that anything's bad, it's just that I can't just start in the middle, which is what I want to do. I want to just start with, I have great news. I want to share news, and I don't want to tell you anything about what has happened in life. But you know, life isn't like that. You do have things that go on, and people do wonder what in the world happened. And if you don't explain it, then they're just thinking, okay, it's like going to be another 6 months till I see anything from you again. And that's fair. That's totally fair. So what I wanted to say really quickly is that life for the last 18 months has been challenging. There have been illnesses and things that have been totally out of our control. 90% of all of it is completely out of our control. And then the other 10% we think we're in control of, and the truth is we're really not anyway. So honestly, it's been a lesson of learning to trust our Lord in what He has given us and what He has taken away from us, and learning to understand, I don't want to say disappointments, but that really is probably the best way to describe it. Things that you think you would be doing, plans that you had, things that he put out in front of you. And I should own this and say me, not you, me. He put out in front of me, and they're just not there anymore. And that's just the way it goes sometimes. And I'm learning to live through disappointment. I might even write a book about this because there is a lot I've been learning, and there's a lot that I've lost through it. Some of it's not bad that you lose things. Sometimes it's okay to shed unnecessary or debilitating things in your life, whether that be situations or jobs or friendships. It doesn't really matter what we're talking about. If it's not healthy and it goes away, as painful as it is, it's probably good to be on the other side of that. So these are just some of the things. I know I'm being very vague, but with sicknesses, with deaths in the family, in friends, things just have not gone the way we thought they would. There have been some unexpected upheaval in our living situation and some difficulties that we've had to deal with that you don't really think you would ever have to deal with. But, and again, being vague, not on purpose, just I don't want to be about the details of the stuff. I want to be more about the big news I have coming and some major updates I have going on, and we're going to get there, okay? There has been some financial strain. I do have to tell you guys this part. I did have to quit my part-time, do-it-anywhere job that would help us go on the road position. I had to quit that. And in doing so, we lost a good portion of the income that we were relying upon to pay off our debt, to get us onto the road, et cetera, et cetera. And as many of you already know, I gave up Patreon, which was also a very lucrative income. And I gave that up. And about 9 months later, I finally got our membership status up on our website, where people, it's similar to Patreon, but instead of paying Patreon to do it, I would get a little bit more money out of your donation, which was a big part of the problem over there, as well as their instability, and some of the clunkiness that was involved with their website and just some business practices I didn't agree with, etc. I needed to do it on my website, plain and simple. That's not as simple as it sounds. I had to actually create a membership website on my own. And I did pay some developers to help me with some of the kinks that I ran into, which ate up any money that I made at the job that I was working. So pretty much all of last year's income went directly into the website, which I thought it would be recouped by now. So that's probably been a poor decision made. I don't know. Whatever. I'm trying not to have regrets about any of the things we've done, just trying to move forward. So like I said, it's just been a lot of challenges. And every time I turned around, there was a new challenge. And so rather than dwelling on the challenges, I thought in the new year, this was the end of 2018, I thought in the new year, I'm going to challenge myself to do something I've never done before. And at the end of that challenge, the reward would be to go on tour. And so most of you, if you're watching this, probably already knew about that. I announced the 100 art pieces in 100 days to be given away to 100 travelers. Travelers is the system that we call our membership site. So if you're a traveler, you pay $10 a month, you're a member, and you get all kinds of exclusive things just being a member there. And it helps pay the way, basically, for us to make videos and do things. So that was the plan. That was the idea. I think I have roughly 25 paintings done. Not quite enough, is it? It's been very close to 100 days. I think we're at day 80 soon. I think we're just under 80 days of the 100 day challenge. And I think I've done maybe 25 paintings. So, I mean, that's where we're at. It's not to say that things don't go wrong, or that I'm a complete and total failure, which I do feel that way sometimes. I struggle with that, but that's another video, I think. I think rather it's to say that it's okay that things don't go the way you planned, and to let go of some of those hopes, which I'm just going to be honest with you. The 100 travelers joining our membership site in 100 days would have helped us have new tires on our motorhome so that we could go on the tour, and would have helped us have a financial stability basis, whatever, that would allow me to do more videos, free videos and paid for videos. And you know, it just would have really been helpful to have that income, knowing that income was there and being able to work on these things. But it didn't happen. And it's just the way it goes, you know. What are you going to do about it? It's time for a sip. So what I learned was that we don't necessarily, all of us, this is like people in general, don't necessarily handle challenges the same. So for me, when I get challenged mentally, spiritually, physically, I allow myself a little bit of time to sort of experience that challenge and whine about it and complain about it. Those close to me know I definitely have no problem complaining about it. But I tend to, okay, that's enough. And now it's time to see how to get through it. That gets harder and harder the more challenges that get thrown at you. So what is initially, you know what, that's just the way life is. I'm going to have to deal with this and pull up my shirt sleeves and let's get into it. That happens like 3-4 times. And then like the fifth or sixth time, it's like, okay, life happens, things are challenging, and I don't want to roll up my sleeves right now. With each challenge, it became more and more difficult to roll up my sleeves. And then it became more and more difficult to say, okay, yeah, that's challenging. Now we're going to push through it. And then it became more and more difficult to even recognize it's just a challenge. I'll get over it. There were times where getting out of bed was a little bit more difficult than it ever had been before. And I'm sure many of you can relate to a lot of what I'm saying. And I don't want to go into all the details of all that. I just want you to know, first of all, you're not alone. So if you're listening to this and you're struggling with something, oh my gosh, you need to know there is someone who is dealing with that exact same thing right now, or who is on the other side of it right now and is willing to hear your side of things and willing to listen to you and willing to just hang out with you and make life a little bit better right now. Reach out. And if you don't have anybody that you can think of, seriously, send me an email, because that is the best part about this entire platform, is connecting with you folks. I just had to say that. So some of the handling of these challenges was a little bit different for each of us. For me personally, I tend to go inside. I tend to think about where I've gone wrong, what I need to do differently. There have been many things in these last 18 months that I've never dealt with before. Drug addiction, that was something that we had to deal with. I'd never dealt with that before. A friend's spouse dying, never had to deal with that before. My grandmother, seeing my grandmother in a way I've never seen her before, that's been a challenge. And the ramifications of the change of our relationship and the dynamics within our home, and teenagers becoming adults, and just so many things that we've had to deal with that I had never dealt with before, all came at one time. And we're still dealing with a lot of this, so it's not like it's over. But like I said in the beginning, it's just all about trusting the one who put us here. And he has a plan. So it brings me to plans. So like I said, I had the 101 or 100 days challenge for myself to do 100 paintings and hopefully give away those 100 paintings to 100 travelers, and over the 100 days be able to be working towards this tour. And I got really sick in the middle of these 100 days, so much so that I didn't do any art for, I think I counted this morning, was 42 days. Zero artwork. Now, I haven't done a lot of artwork this year at all, but to go 42 days in a row without picking up a paintbrush or anything, pretty disappointing. So that in itself really put a damper on the 100-day challenge, because number one, when I started this thing, I had 100 days to do it. So you have to kind of do work every day. Number two, I also had some little benchmarks for myself along the way where I would be announcing, here's what I've done, we only have this many days left, make sure you come. I missed a great deal of those because I was so sick. So there was no updates. There was no public announcements. There were no, hey, don't forget, I'm still doing this challenge, because I really wasn't. So that was a little difficult. So I never really got the message out there. And along the way, I was supposed to be telling you about the tour, because again, this was all leading up to the tour. And as it got closer to, we should really be planning this tour, like specific dates and places where we're going, and talk to some of the people that could host us and those kind of, and it all fell flat. Like, I can't even put a word on how flat that was. It just, that's the word, okay? Which means, in all reality, not going on the tour, right? Because if you don't make plans for a two-week trip across the country, how in the world do you plan to do it? How do you do a trip like that just because you decide one day today, I'm just going to go do a tour? It doesn't work like that. You have to make plans. You have to have locations to go to, and you have to have people to show up at them, and you have to sell tickets, and you have to have money, because you can't just go across the country without money. It doesn't work. So I had pretty much figured we weren't going. Just not going to happen. And then Mr. Crafter's mom got really sick at the end of her life and has since passed away. And in this is all in the midst of, we're going on this tour or not going on this tour. I don't even know what to do. And so, all right, we're not going to go. We'll just go to services in Montana. And then that became a mess as well. The bottom line is, once the services were solidified and we knew that's where we were going and what dates we were going, Mr. Crafter turns to me and says, we have earned a vacation. We're going to go and we're going to do this tour, whatever that means. So figure it out. So I've spent the last week frantically figuring it out, and I just want to show you real quick. This is the finalized list. I'm going to be there. This is the finalized list. It's finalized because it only has two marks crossed out. Anyway, that's the finalized list of where we will be publicly, when we will be there, and you can learn all about that at a link in the description or up in the dooley bobber thingy where the iCard is. Hopefully you can find that. Anyway, the bottom line is this. We are going on tour. That's the big news. That's the big, huge update. Da-da-da-da. You've just been watching for 20 minutes and now you get your reward. We are going on tour. And where we are going is Amarillo, Texas, Memphis, Tennessee, Nashville, Tennessee, Greer, South Carolina, Mobile, Alabama, New Orleans, Louisiana, Shreveport, Louisiana, and San Antonio, Texas. Now, we're going to be in places in between, but these are the spots where we're going to have public locations for you to attend for free. Yes, we are not only just doing this tour, but we are footing the entire bill ourselves. I'm a little scared to say that because that's, I don't know how. Anyway, the bottom line is that's what we've decided. Now, if you would like to help us with that, we will not turn you away. There are ways that you can help, most importantly, with your prayers. So there are a whole bunch of options for people if they want to be a part of things, if they know of a place where we could park our motor home overnight on the way. There's a whole bunch of things like that that you can do. So, or if you even know of a place where we could have a public gathering, like a private room in a restaurant or something like that, that we could maybe rent or eat food in lieu of rent of it. I don't know how some of those places work, but you get the idea, I think. Basically, the bottom line is there is a blog post with all of the information and a link to a really cool thing that I set up. It's basically a form, and you reserve your tickets by choosing the place you want to go. So like if you're near Amarillo, Texas, it's Sunday, April 28th. I know time is running out. But if you're in or near Amarillo, Texas, Sunday 28th of April, and you would like to come and meet us, we would love to meet you. Then you'll just click that button, and then that lets us know that there will be people coming to that event. And then there's a place for you to tell us how many are in your party, including yourself, so that we know we have a big enough room. And then, like I said, it's free. You just come out and we'll take pictures with each other and we'll talk about your art experiences. And it would just be really awesome to just give you a hug in person. I do like to hug people, so I hope that's okay. But that if it's not, you're just gonna have to say no hugs, please. But anyway, the bottom line is that's what we're gonna do. It's called Meeting Friends Tour. We are meeting our friends in the southern United States. Not everybody, because we can't go across the ocean and meet our friends over there, but we are meeting everybody we can in the southern states. Hopefully, you can come out and see us at one of the dates and times that we have listed. And I don't have the exact location of where we'll be, like, at the Perkins on 24th Street. I don't have any of that yet because, like I said, I need to hear if you're coming or not. And if you're coming, then we know what we need to reserve. So get right to that. Go fill that out and meet with us, okay? That I'm just so excited about that part. So let me check my list here. I wanted to make sure I've been working on this for a while now. Several days of calling and videoing and emailing back and forth with people who are along the tour route that we want to meet up with personally and spend some time with them personally. People who have been supporters of the Kraaft Shaak since day one, people who have continued to support even when we had no Patreon, people who continued to support after the Patreon fiasco and then joined our travelers membership site on our website. All of you have been contacted, and if you there are a couple people I haven't heard from yet. So if you're getting this and you're like, well, wait a minute, you didn't contact me, go check your email because there's probably an email that you haven't responded to from me. So go check that out. And if it does seem like I missed you somehow, then feel free to reach out to me because it wasn't intentional or it got lost in the mail, which has happened a bunch lately. So anyway, the bottom line is we are going on tour. Life has been challenging. Doesn't really matter. You pick yourself up by the bootstraps and you keep on trucking. We are headed forward with everything we're doing. Not much has changed as far as our challenges. It's not like they've gone away or they're not, we can now tour the country freely or any of these things. We are just taking a 2-week break from April 28th until May 7th. That break that we are taking, those are the public dates, by the way. We are touring from here to South Carolina and back again. Here is Arizona, for those of you who don't know. And we're just going to enjoy our time on the road and away from responsibilities for a couple weeks, and then we come right back to it all. So this is just a break, really. And as far as live videos and YouTube videos, I had a computer issue in the middle of all this too, so I stopped being able to even edit any of the videos that I had recorded previously. But now my computer's working, as you can see, because I'm putting out a video right now. But the bottom line is I want to be able to do more of those things, but life just isn't allowing me to right now. And I'm learning to be okay with that. I know it's challenging. I know it's not exactly what you want to hear. And I'm sure that a video with some art playing in the background is not quite what you were after when you signed up here, but at least it's something. Trying really hard to just do something. That's what we're after these days. So I will tell you, it would be nice to get back to doing some art again. So if anything, pay attention to Instagram and YouTube. Those are the two places where I am always on Instagram, always. And, you know, in fact, if you're watching this and you're not a member of our Discord crafters community, you're actually missing out on interaction and challenges and all kinds of things. So there is a link down below for the new crafters community 2.0. Yes, it means you have to sign up for something called Discord. You probably won't use it for anything else. So who cares? The bottom line is it's a place where you can connect with other crafters. You can post pictures. You can comment on other people's stuff. You can get video updates of all the crafters who are a part of it, who if they upload a video to their YouTube channel, it automatically gets posted there so you can see it. There, it's different. I'm not gonna lie. It's different than anything you've seen before, but it's available on your phone, your mobile device, or your laptop, or your desktop. And I mean, you're able to access it from just about anything, anywhere, anytime. And it is actually quite a lot of fun. And we do monthly get-togethers for travelers, everything in this one place. Travelers, hitchhikers, crafters, everybody all in one place, and everybody gets to interact with each other there. It's the best of all the worlds I've ever wanted. It's almost like having a Kraaft Shaak app, but it's not exclusive to Kraaft Shaak. It's called Discord, and it is typically used by gamers, but we're changing that. Come on over and help us do it. So again, that link for that is down below. We're there to help you if you don't fully understand all the bits and pieces, and it's fine. We'll learn it together. And the best part of this whole thing is it's a closed community, which means you have to ask to join it. So we're not going to have anybody in there doing things that we don't like. We are very particular about who we let in. So if you do join and ask to join, you'll have to answer some questions. And once you do that, if you answer correctly, then we'll let you in and you get to have some fun. And if not, no big deal. So anyway, it's just something I wanted to make sure I shared with you guys. And this video is getting quite long, so I think I am gonna let it go for now. And hopefully the image above has entertained you while I told my bleak, terrible, boring story to get to the wonderful, huge, big time news and updates. So I look forward to hearing from you guys. Please leave a comment below about what you've missed here at the Kraaft Shaak. If there's something you'd like to see that you haven't seen in a while, or maybe you've never seen it here before and you're interested in seeing it for the first time, let me know. I need some ideas. Get me crafting again. All right. Bye, everybody. Have a crafty day.